Okay, so hopefully people can hear me. I have a microphone on. And I just did. Okay, I'm going to minimize that. Actually, no, I need the chat window open so I can actually talk to people if anyone shows up. Alrighty. Hello and welcome. My name is Travis Duncan Stewart, and I have purchased for myself a very lovely and expensive and hopefully compact new computer. This is the MSI Creator P100X mini PC, which has an Intel i9-10900K, an RTX 2080 Super, and I bought this because for what I paid for this, I could have built my own system. However, this is convenient because I have a very minimal space right now to keep a PC, and having a full-size case in here is not, you know, a doable thing right now. So this should be kind of the best, you know, the best of both worlds solution, getting a smaller system with a lot of raw power behind it, but then also not sort of, you know, dead-ending myself with a mini PC where what I buy is what I'm stuck with. MSI has created this to be a upgradable PC, assuming Intel still supports LGA 1200 in the future. I think I could fit an RTX 3080, if not even a 3090 in here. The issue then becomes power supply, because this thing is using an ITX, or not ITX, an SFX sized power supply, which I think I'm limited by how big of one I can put in there. I know Seasonic makes an 800 watt supply, but it's a larger frame, so it might not fit in here after everything's taken apart. But for getting a computer in my hands that works and I can work with, this was kind of my best option. So now the fun part of opening it for the first time. And let's see what we find there. I guess, disclaimer, I paid for this. I bought this with my own money. I have received nothing from MSI or any other sponsors. This is literally the first computer I've bought in the last 4 years. And my last one was the laptop, which I'm currently using right now to stream this. Hey, we have a viewer. Who's watching? I post this to Facebook and Discord, so probably 20 people I know, unless some randos subscribers are watching, which never happens. Hello, viewers. So the important and stuff out of the way, keyboard and mouse combo, which I'm not sure if I'll end up using this due to the fact that I already have a wireless keyboard and a mouse, but it's always nice to have spares. The fun thing too is, like, I've tried researching this computer extensively, and there's not much information out there that's not from MSI. There's very few independent reviews. Any independent reviews I did find were either European markets or Asian markets. I think there's an Italian site I found, and also a Taiwanese site that had reviews. Ooh. So, we'll... This is really packed in there. Holy shit. Okay. Step one. Get the keyboard out of here. So, basic white MSI keyboard that matches the same color scheme and branding as the computer itself. Ooh. No, I'm not doing keycap ASMR right now. switches on the or legs on the back to elevate it, which is standard. Does not appear to have a USB pass-through on it, which is sad, considering usually that's kind of standard nowadays. But I guess, I mean, when you're getting a free included keyboard, no one really cares what features they do or do not give you. An MSI mouse, the PM10 mouse, which is not bad, feels nice. Scroll wheel, third button. Not a bad little mouse to go along with this either. All right. Yeet! Get that out of there. Next lovely little box here. Much smaller. Probably warranty cards and power cables and all that fun stuff. Yeah, power cable for the tower. An extra SATA cable, which is weird because this thing of two and a half inch drives pre-installed. So I'm hoping that's just a redundant spare in the event of a failure. Then the documentation, thumb screws, and then actual, I got four Phillips head screws in here and then six thumb screws. I know this thing uses thumb screws on the back of it, so I'm curious how that goes. Yes, thumb screw replaces. Okay. So I have to replace the stock screws with thumb screws. Great. Quick start guide. MSI card thing, whatever. That's all for later. More yeets. Alrighty. What's that thing? Okay, no. I thought I had some absurdly large thing down there. I didn't want to have to drop. Okay, here it comes. This lovely 10 that's stuck in there. Me being a fool carrying this thing, punched in the handles, which then led to, can I do this? There we go. Instant table. And turn you on the side. And of course, it's very well packed in this high density foam. I'll turn it this way so I can do this. Yeah, it has a really high density foam that doesn't have much crush to it, which is really good, knowing that my computer is safe in shipping until I get my grubby hands on it. I'm trying to stabilize my little impromptu table here so it's not going to break on me. Alrighty, push you around. So I got this is the front side of it. Pull this off. And it's funny, for the measurements, I looked at this thing, like this thing is actually a little bit bigger than I expected, but it's still very sleek and very form. Alrighty. How do I do this? I just want to put this down. Yeah. And pull the bag off in the wrong direction, because of course the logo is right there. Nice durable storage shipment bag, whatever you want to call it. And, what are you? Rust protection paper. Glorious. Alrighty. Tap a foot or something there. And there she is. That is a beauty. 10th gen Core i9, as it says. That's heavy too. I mean, there's a lot packed into this little beast. Yeah, it's very sleek. RTX 2080 in the back here. Thunderbolt, the main reason I bought this, because of course my laptop's Thunderbolt. I have a whole bunch of Thunderbolt arrays plugged into it so I can have expansion, and it just made sense to stay in Thunderbolt's economy. So now, the fun part everyone loves. Whoa. I've never been crazy for doing the peels off this stuff, but like I also habitually hate things that still have peels on them. And it drives me crazy when people don't like remove it. And then there's all just basic components here being covered. Is there a tab? There we go. That does not come as easily. Dust on it. Okay. And then what do we got down here? Around the feet base. Swear to God, if I pull a line and drop myself so much. Oh, there we go. Now, one thing the website didn't really have much of was a lot of the specs for like what's in here. As I look at it on the bottom, I have some intake fans. I think those are intake. And there's only two of them down here. There's a screw for one of them there. Theoretically, a third one could go here, but I think the power supply is on this side. So that's why that is probably free up for the power supply's intake. Let's see here. So now, so the screws there. So of course, this thing is all, you know, has the factory sealed stickers over the screws because, you know, hey, warranty and all that fun stuff. But of course, we avoid warranties around here. I want the micro tip or don't the... Yeah, I'm going to use the smaller tip. Nope. There we go. Okay, so if I expose this panel, really? Okay. Yeah, it was actually coming off pretty easily. And I dropped it. That's fine. I got the thumb screws put in place here. Screw them. I'm just going to purge straight into that. Okay. I saved one of them. Huzzah. Alrighty. So pop this off. That comes off really easily, which is nice. Okay, so this is the graphics card side. So there we have, got the RTX 20 Super, which I think is MSI's Ventus model or whatever. I think it's a little different. Yeah, so because of, I guess, the spacing of this thing, there's actually a fin on here versus the actual Ventus. I've seen it a little further, so that's interesting. Now, the physical space appears to be triple slot because there's an extra little bit here. So I'm curious to see like what larger graphics cards I could put in here. The other question is the power draw for it. Power supply is right there. There's the back of the motherboard. And of course, there's an M.2 slot there. Install a second M.2. This does come with one pre-installed M.2. I think it's a 1 terabyte. And then on the backside here, there are two 2.5 inches. I think both 2 terabytes each. Where did my screws go? I'm going to do this now. I'm going to do it proper. So thumb screws. It also looks like, oh, it's not a zip top bag? Damn. This is why we have knives. No one wants to see me topless, Gordon. But thank you for your faith. Your blind, mistrusted faith in my abilities. Alrighty, let's get these. This is the side panel back on. So I'm going to rip the other one off. Faith and mistrust, the two most terrible people to ever rely upon. Okay, it does go up there. It goes back on pretty easily, which is nice. Oop. Of course, if the thumb screw could actually thread the hole, that'd be even more amazing. There we go. Some weird flex in the case as I'm trying to do this, and I think it's just the footing being weird. There we go. Ah. Okay, this top piece is not as stable as one would expect, so there's that. Talk for me in a different accent.
Well, I am Scottish, so I could use a Scottish accent and talk like that for a few minutes. Does that suit your fancy?
My voice isn't deep enough, actually, for proper Scottish.
Sorry. My voice isn't deep enough for proper Scottish, but I am of the blood of the Scottish Highlands, so, you know, it's in my heritage. Lovely, lovely heritage. And yes, I do have a slight lisp when I talk like a Scotsman. Do you approve of haggis? Haggis is a beautiful dish. Everyone says haggis is disgusting. You know what's disgusting? Hot dogs. You at least know it's in haggis. You don't know it's in a hot dog. Hot dogs are full of crazy shit. Haggis is gizzards and organs and oatmeal. It's delicious. I will fight any man who says otherwise. Alrighty. Second panel off. You're gonna stay there? Okay, good. Alrighty. Oh, it only comes with one 2.5 inch. Oh, right, it's, yeah. Right, it's a pre-installed 2 terabyte SSD on this side, and then one open sled for another. But then why do... Oh, yes, okay, so the extra screws I have in here, these screws right here, I think are standoffs. Are those standoffs? I believe so. They appear to be the same. So. That's why we have the shutter cable. Solving all the mysteries. Thank you for keeping time. I usually just keep rambling on until someone tells me to shut up. So, alrighty. So we have in here, on this side, a 650-watt power supply, which is modular, which is very nice. But I think this is only 100 millimeters deep, so I will be extremely limited by how much I can push the power of this thing, unless I start rearranging cables around here, because I don't think I'll get 30 millimeters for the 800 watt that I saw. Unless, no, this is my my power riser down here. There's a, I'm trying to show this towards the camera a little bit here. There's stainless steel little box right here. That's the riser for the power cable connection. So I'm guessing I can't go crazy and put a bigger power supply in here, even if I want to. I think a 750 watt would fit in here, but then if I were to put a 2080 in here, I would require at least a little more headroom, because I think people were testing 3080 on 750 watt power supplies and still shorting out because they were going above and beyond. But then now let's see here. Okay, so they have, why would they install in that slot? Not the fuck. Okay, so this thing only has 32 gigabytes of RAM in it, which I was aware of. I was gonna upgrade the RAM, but they've put the included RAM stick in the slot furthest from the CPU. So I'll have to remove the I have to remove the fan and probably the CPU cooler to install more RAM. But I'm already trying to source a 64 gigabyte RAM kit for this thing just to have the extra oomph behind it. But otherwise, like, this thing actually, it's looking pretty good. I heard a lot of complaints that, oh, this thing, you know, it runs too hot or it runs noisy. I mean, I could probably put a more efficient fan in here. This is a standard-ish size. I think it's a 140 millimeter fan. Or maybe a 120 millimeter fan. And then the cooler is quite nice. You can sort of see under all that. There's a fair bit of heat pipes to it. So this should suffice as my new system, as everything seems pretty decent. And yeah, it's hopefully going to last me for several years because I can upgrade what I need to, rip out the CPU and put a new one in there if 11th gen or 12th gen Intels still support LGA 1200. And then, yeah, I can put in larger drives. I can put up to a 4 terabyte SSD in each side here. I'm assuming these are SSD. I'm looking at them and I'm going like, oh, wait, no. These are, they are standard HDD 2.5 inches. So they won't be lightning fast, but I have the power to change that. Now, how this thing back on here?
I'll do a quick case tour of the IO in a second here. As I drop a thumb screw on my desk. Oh, there you are. Hiding by my screw bits. Alrighty. Where was that? There was that one. The biggest thing I'm looking forward to with this, not sure my friend will hear me right now. One second. Let me put this thumb screw and get back up here. The biggest thing I'm looking forward when humans lose people typically pour a little alcohol in their honor. If you have isopropyl alcohol, I do have isopropyl alcohol right here. I actually don't have any dead computers right now. I have a laptop that won't power on, but I think it's a issue with the battery. I've already has replaced it before. And I'm not going to bother replacing it again. Like, it's a 6-7-year-old laptop that I bought many, many, many years ago while on the go. And it served me well, but I got to rip out the hard drive and back up all the data on there because I have no more need for that laptop. So yeah, the big reason why I'm happy to get this thing is because like my little HP Spectre I have right now, which is also Thunderbolt, it's only a dual core i7, so it doesn't have much processing power. Like, I've learned how to flat out cap it out and bottleneck it by just like throwing a little bit too much at it. We did a live stream months ago with it, and I had to like cut back a whole bunch of settings and kill a whole bunch of stuff in my computer to run the live stream, because otherwise, like, if I threw even an internet browser at it, it's like, nope, too much, and capped out. So on the back here, there's not a Type-C port in the RTX 2080. I thought there was one by spec. Oh well. On the back here, we have three display ports and one HDMI port in the 2080 Super. And then on the back side here, I got your standard five audio connections, left and right, center and right, rear subwoofer, that's what that is. And then I also have a mic input, I have an optical out, a CMOS clear button, and then I have the Thunderbolt port in here, which is gonna be the big thing to just basically pop this into my whole system. 10 gigabit type C or 10 gigabit USB type A, 2.5 gigabit LAN connector, and then 2 5 gigabit USB 3s, and then I think these are 2 USB 2.0s for the peripherals. And then I got the HDMI port and the display port on the motherboard covered up, because I'm assuming they've just been might be turned off. I'll look in the BIOS and see that. But yeah, this is a nice little system. I mean, like, yeah, it's huge from the side, but like, at least from the profile, it's minimal. It's weird how the whole panel here is vented to allow for airflow, but then like, there's only really air being drawn in here by the power supply. And then my brain's just weirding out for a second here because, okay, yeah, so they have a weird honeycomb pattern on this thing, but I can see the GPU behind here. So yeah, GPU and power supply drawing the air. This is the CPU fan here. And I guess it's strange how the panel doesn't have any actual openings over top of the hard drives, because I think you at least want a little bit of airflow on them, because they can heat up. So for their testing, I'm pretty sure by the time I'm done with this thing, like, if, you know, I go upgrade it, there's gonna be a lot of Frankensteining to it. But yeah, that is the MSI Creator P100X Creator PC, which, again, like, there's literally no coverage on this computer. And even before I was gonna go for this, I was gonna buy the Asus ProArt DM490X or 940X DX, whatever it is. I can't remember the model name now, which was a smaller system than this. This is the 10 liter case, and the ProArt was a 8.5 liter case.
but this has far more expansion capabilities because I can actually put in a new GPU, I can put in a new processor. The ProArt doesn't have that, and also like Asus is dead in the water on like any release information for the ProArt. At least I could physically see this in a store and buy it, versus, you know, just seeing the coming soon for over a year. But I'm happier about this because, yeah, it's the 10th generation. It's LGA 1200, which is supposed to get supported at least all the way through 11th gen, hopefully up to 12th gen for Intel. So, I mean, who knows if Intel starts making higher core count processors, I could potentially have like, you know, maybe 14, 16 or more cores in this thing if they do a better process. And also, I can probably shove this into a Pelican case if I really wanted to take this somewhere and work on the fly and have, you know, full power available versus having a laptop with me. So we'll see. Because I think, yeah, I have a Pelican rolling case I haven't used in decades, and it should fit this, I believe. So that's it. Thank you for joining me. I'm going to end the stream here. It was a lovely almost half hour. Thank you to Gordon for their color commentary in the chat here. Don't think anyone else is ever watching this, despite I posted this like three different areas. And yeah, thank you for watching. This will be on the YouTube channel, and I will do a full review of this after I've set up